the New World Order.
We have the New World Order.
Far be it for me to question you, Your Highness, but might not the New World Order be better served by approaching the humans with a more benevolent hand?
And suffer further rebel insults? The High Evolutionary is right. They must be crushed! Begin your preparations, my knights. The destiny of the New World Order will be fulfilled.
Attention, humans. By order of the High Evolutionary, you are commanded to vacate your homes immediately. Those who do not comply will be vacated by force. Identification confirmed. Next. Step inside. You are under arrest for unauthorized altering of an identification implant. Come with us, rebel.
No, wait! It must have been defective! I'm not a rebel!
The assassin is Gambit. People are afraid. They want action. They want protection. They want revenge. The mutant control law is passed, calling for an army of sentinels. They march over the nation, seeking out mutants, hunting them down like animals.
Surrender, mutant!
Some fight back. But not for long. The Sentinels herd the surviving mutants into detention camps. The camps are your final stop. You never leave. Never! But those who control the Sentinels don't stop with mutants. Eventually, they bring their new world order to all humans.
Terrans who accept the Neo-Sapien peace will be tolerated in the New World Order. Those who refuse and resist will be eliminated.
You will always have a special place in my heart and in the New World Order.
Ghoulish isn't our vampire, Mrs. C.
Maybe you can ask Santa what he saw before he was bitten.
Right. Retrace his steps. Maybe pull a couple of his teeth for DNA samples.
Mandy! I'm getting presents in the New World... I'm getting presents in the New World Order! I'm getting presents in the New World Order! Mrs. Claus said so!
Now off to the cellar with the lot of you. Christmas won't save itself.
The affirmative task we have now is to actually create a new world order, because the global order is changing again, and the institutions and the rules.
Our constitutional journey did not stop then, and it must not stop now, Judge, and we'll be faced with equally consequential decisions in the 21st century. Can a microscopic tag be implanted in a person's body to track his every movement? There's actual discussion about that. You will rule on that, mark my words, before your tenure is over. Can brain scans be used to determine whether a person is inclined toward criminality or violent behavior? You will rule on that.
The only people who don't want to disclose the truth are people with something to hide.
President Obama called for a new U.S. role on the world stage.
So we have to shape an international order that can meet the challenges of our generation.
Echoing a phrase made famous by the first President Bush.
We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order.
The international order we seek is one that can resolve the challenges of our time.
We had a worldview. Republican and Democratic presidents alike, from Harry Truman to George Bush. President Bush kept said, and it's a phrase that I often use myself, that we needed a new world order.
A new world order.
The international order we seek is one that can resolve the challenges of our time.
An order in which a credible United Nations can use its peacekeeping role to fulfill the promise and vision of the UN's founders.
This five-pointed star was man. And if you flip it upside down, the upside-down five-pointed star with the goat, with his chinny-chin-chin and his ears and his horns, was the sign of Satan worshippers, a satanic star. Now, you can see on the American flag, our stars are right side up. But around the year 2000, the Republican Party changed their logo from the stars being right side up to the stars being upside down, coincided with the coming on the scene of George W. Bush and Karl Rove. Very strange. I think they need an exorcism.
When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order.
Shape an international order.
A new world order.
A new world order.
Look, this isn't a conspiracy thing. They like the idea of a global government that sort of micromanages everybody.
Good evening, everybody. President Obama and British Prime Minister Gordon today calling for a new world order to tackle our global economic crisis.
There is a global meltdown coming. It is a global depression, and one world currency and one world financial system is the end game. China said last week they want one global currency. France said yesterday or the day before that they want one world order, a new world order, at the end of this event.
I wanted to ask you, friends of ours that live in France have a medical card and there is a chip on it that has all of their medical information from birth to whatever age they are. That scared me, frankly, because I said to them, well, how do you want the government knowing all of your business from cradle to grave? I believe our country was founded on independence, and I think we can all agree on this, whether you're Democrat or Republican. I think it's important that we have privacy between our doctor and our health records, and it shouldn't be shared with the government.
Governor Dean?
And if you could tell me under what moral jurisdiction the Constitution allows you to do that.
You can get, if you have the chip, you can carry the records with you. They can stick it in the computer. They can know all your situations. If you've been in a terrible car accident and you can't tell them anything, you have that. The doctor has the information. They know.
So we just heard the White House they're brushing this off, saying it's not really a big deal. But should Americans be alarmed?
Americans should be extremely alarmed. Look at the NDAA, where the president's saying he can secretly kill Americans and have bags put over our head and have us thrown into black vans to disappear forever. Or look at the TSA and the airports groping people. Look at the drones in our skies. Look at Army checkpoints now, the end of Posse Comitatus. What's dangerous about this Cold War era emergency legislation is that it was for basically nuclear war. So we have a president and others saying they take orders from the UN, and they're taking legislation designed for when the US is under a nuclear attack and everything's been destroyed basically, and they're saying we're going to use this in peacetime. So that's the difference. And we see the president shutting down power plants without congressional approval, so his buddies make more money with their power plants that are left on. We see the president nationalizing General Motors, giving tens of trillions to foreign banks. We see the president signing legislation to charge people with felonies if they protest at national security events. All of this is part of an acceleration. It was incremental. Now it's an acceleration towards classical tyranny. And so we would be insane if we weren't concerned about this new executive order. Well, the president may try to implement this. It's still unconstitutional. It's still illegal. They can pass an NDAA saying they can kill me and no one ever knows where I went. Literally blow my head off, tie a chain around me, throw me in the ocean. They're saying they have that power. I say it's illegal. I say it's a violation of common law, Bill of Rights, Constitution. But if Obama launches new wars in Syria or other areas without congressional approval, that impeachment begins. That has not been on any globalist corporate New World Order media here in the United States. Not ABC, not Fox, not CNN. None of them have covered that impeachment proceedings have begun. Look, there's major power grabs happening, and if we don't stand up and decry them, we're all in serious, serious danger.
I got your note. Are you okay?
I can't talk. She's listening.
No, she's not. She's with Miss White. And you need to tell me what they're doing to you, because if you're in danger, I'll take you out of here.
No matter where I go, she'll find me.
Okay, so we're not going to let her. Now, you said in your note that they put something inside of you. What was it?
A computer chip.
Mackenzie.
It has all my information on it. It knows everywhere I go. That's how they found me yesterday. Okay, I can't hide.
They didn't find you. We did. And there's no computer chip inside you.
There is. Look.
Looks like you got a shot.
She was in a shot. That's how Dr. Zadok put it in.
Look, there's nothing in your arm. They probably told you that so you would behave.
No! Okay, I'm not lying. It's for real. Please just feel it.
It's time. What is that?
I told you. A computer chip.
Actually, it's an RFID chip. Radio frequency identification.
Like they put in dogs.
It's the same basic technology.
So the birds can track every single move their daughter makes.
Not yet. In the future, chips will be equipped with GPS. But for now, they simply carry a 16-digit number unique to each client.
So why would the Burtons freak their kid out now if they can't even put her under surveillance yet?
To save her life. If she were ever in an accident, the hospital could scan the implant and retrieve valuable medical information.
So can any third-rate hacker, or Uncle Sam for that matter. How much private information can you put in these chips?
The applications are unlimited. In the future, we'll be able to track children, the elderly, criminals, immigrants.
Welcome to the New World Order.
Just so you know, nobody forced Mackenzie into this. I don't do any implantations on children without their consent.
How could you put that inside your child without her consent?
I didn't. She wanted it.
Mackenzie? Is that true?
I had to say I did. If I didn't, she'd never let me go outside again.
Kiddo, you were not being punished.
Sweetie. Honey, you know how much I worry about you. I just want to keep you safe.
You don't even like me. You just want Ella back.
Mackenzie!
Superman.
Yes, we can. 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 Yes, we can.
Houston, yes we can.
Houston.
Join the Navy.
They're recruiting people with subliminal messages.